The violence claimed their lives, and now they are at peace. A father and his infant son were laid to rest today, but not before many people packed inside a church to say their final goodbyes. Anchor LaTanya Norton has that story all new at 10.
Misty, overcast conditions fit the somber occasion Saturday morning. Mourners assemble at St. John Baptist Church in the 8500 block of Panola Street in the Leonidas neighborhood as pallbearers load not one, but two caskets into a hearse. The first, 7-month-old Deshaun Kennard, the city's youngest murder victim of 2013. The second, his father, 25-year-old Deshaun Butler. Both father and son murdered, remembered, and laid to rest together.
It's hard. You know, it's hard because, you know, you've seen them from they were a child, as they're growing up, you know. You don't expect to do this, you know. You don't expect to do this.
Albert Fiesel mourns the loss of his grandson and the great-grandson he'll never know.
You can't get no innocent than that, you know. 7-month-old, just, you know, just beginning to live, you know, not even walking.
It's just senseless. You know, we steady killing each other, you know, and I don't know if it was gang-related.
Police say the 9 p.m. fatal shooting on November 13th may have been gang-related. The two were riding in the back seat of a car in the 2100 block of General de Gaulle Drive near the Crescent City Connection when someone opened fire. The father died at the scene while his son, fastened in his car seat, was pronounced dead at a local hospital.
We have to take a stand. Every family, every neighborhood, every church, every mosque, everybody has to come together. Because if not, it's just not going to stop.
It's really sad. It's most definitely sad. The baby's 7 months, and the baby's kin to me.
Two lives tragically taken too soon as mourners pray for strength and for the violence to stop.
When we're weak, he's strong. And that's what we rely on, Jesus.
On your side, LaTanya Norton, WDSU News.
Please call Crime Stoppers at 822-1111 if you have any information that might be able to help police in this case. That reward now stands at $15,000. Right now,